So, hello there. Thank you for coming back. Or if you're new, thank you for stopping by. So, today I want to talk about the most successful crops we grow in 2020 at Fen Tomato Farm. So, the crops that don't ask for too much labor, it's not labor intense, and they're easier to grow and they're more thought after, the ones that customers like the most. So, of course, we're gonna start with tomatoes. That's the most important crop for us. That's what we're known as, tomato growers. So, let's get started. I've chosen just the most favorite ones. Not gonna tell you all the varieties because we grew 35 varieties and it's too much to talk about them. But my favorite varieties gonna start it. Green Zebra, which is very nice variety. Nice and fleshy, really looks nice in the salad and has such a sweet, nice taste to it as well. Also, a variety called Indigo, Indigo Rose. Absolutely love that variety. It's fantastic to grow. You can see it in here. It's amazing taste. Amazing shape, amazing color. Not too big, not too small, just the perfect size. Another variety is Moonglow. It's an orangey color beef tomato. It's a big fleshy tomato as well. Was ever so sweet. The taste was fantastic. I made some sauce from that variety, but in the salad were just cut up with a bit of olive oil and salt. Didn't need anything else with it. Also very nice variety. Another one was Latvian Yellow as well. It's a beef variety, very nice, very sweet, and again makes my mouth watering, and again we loved it very much. So another crop that has done very well for us is the lettuce. Lettuce is a good crop to grow. It's selling good on markets and sold very well in the farm shop. Also, the third variety, the third crop that we grew and done very well to us is the radish. We grew that throughout the whole year because nearly every week we were sowing a little bit of radish because radish grows very quick. So we were sowing every week, so we have continuity over throughout the year. So that was a good crop to grow. Also, the fourth crop, gherkin cucumbers, they've got more taste than the normal big cucumbers, the long ones, and we loved it. Customers loved it very much. It was a very good product. Don't require too much looking after, not too much labor in it. Just need to get it started, basically put it on the strings, then it's growing quick, much quicker than the tomatoes, so it's a good successful crop. Another thing we find it that will be the fifth crop is the aubergines. We grew five varieties of aubergines, but the best ones, we loved it as well, and the customers did love very much as well, is the long ones, which are called Farmer's Long. They did so well, and so many people was amazed by the shape, by the color, and how good the taste is, because they taste a bit sweeter than the normal aubergine. And another one was the round stripy aubergine, the little ones. They're very good for stuffing. So many people was amazed by the look. How they're looking, they fantastic, cook very quick, and again taste very nice. One other thing that we loved growing was the melons. And again, they perform very well. They sold very good, and the customers loved very much. We grew six varieties of melons. The best one was unusual one is the tiger melon. You can see here. And the watermelon. Watermelons We had a nice variety. They grew huge. The big one, we grew, of course, we had loads of them, but the big one was 12 and a half kilograms. And they sold very well as well. We didn't grow enough actually because we had more demand of watermelon and we didn't grow enough. Melons and watermelons are a very, very easy crop to grow. And of course, they are very nice and very thought after. One other crop, I lost the count now, I'm gonna need to write it down, is growing okra. Okra performed very well as well, and it was a very, very good buy. Customers loved it and very, very thought after. It sold very well. Every time, whatever we picked and whatever we took to the market, it was selling everything, like 2 to 1. And it's good to grow. It's not that hard to grow okra. We didn't, it was first year for us, but we find it very easy to grow okra. So the ninth crop we have grow that was a really, really good success as well, very thought after and very easy to sell because customers loved it very much, is chilies. Chilies we had ranging from very, very hot, which on the heat scale there would be over 1 million, and to very, very mild, which is 8,000 on a heat scale. Which shall I say, we've been growing jalapenos, green and orange, some other varieties that are a little bit stronger, up to Trinidad scorpion and up to ghost. Another successful crop that we liked it to grow and had a good demand was the zucchini, especially the yellow ones. They taste better than the green ones, as all the customers were saying that. And we find that as well. They're not very labor intense, so it's a good crop if you're looking for something to just get started. So these are the 10 successful crops that we grew on the farm. We're looking for crops that don't demand too much labor, like it's not labor intense, because it's only three of us working the farm, so we need to be everywhere and see everything because we're growing so much variety of things. So in this case, in choosing your crops, then it's more manageable. Of course, we grew other crops as well, but I just chose the best ones and the more easy ones to grow. I also done some experimenting growing on the farm. I grew some ginger, which yes, it done okay. You can see a separate video up here about growing the ginger. Also, I start growing some miniature banana plants. That's another experiment as well, which they should be looking like this. We'll see. They will have a long way to go to become nice bananas like this. So that's it for today. Hope you find this interesting. Please subscribe, thumbs up, give us a comment. I very much love to get engaging with our viewers and hope you'll come back. Bye for now.